టుడే అవర్ టాపిక్ ఇస్ కంట్రివెన్సీస్ ఫర్ క్రాస్ పాలినేషన్. క్రాస్ పాలినేషన్ ఈస్ అడ్వాంటేజియస్ టు ప్లాంట్స్ ఇన్ మెనీ వేస్ దాన్ ది సెల్ఫ్ పాలినేషన్. సో ద ప్లాంట్స్ ఎగ్జిబిట్ సర్టెన్ స్పెషల్ కంట్రివెన్సీస్ టు ఎన్ష్యూర్ క్రాస్ పాలినేషన్. సమ్ ఆఫ్ సచ్ అడాప్టేషన్స్ ఆర్ హియర్. దోస్ ఆర్ ది 7 అడాప్టేషన్స్. They are dichogamy, nothing but unisexuality, dichogamy. In this dichogamy, protandry and protogyny is there, heterogamy, heterostyle, self-sterility, pollen prepotency, sensitive stigmas. Now we will discuss about these 7 types of adaptations under the cross-pollination controversies. Dichogamy, nothing but unisexuality, defines in some plant species flowers have either androecium or gynoecium. Such flowers are called as unisexual flowers. That means in a flower any one sex organ is present, either androecium or gynoecium. Such flowers are known as unisexual flowers. Such production is known as dichogamy. In this dichogamy we have to observe the two phenomena, those are the monoecious and dioecious. Monoecious means both male and female flowers may develop on the same plant. Example is Coccus nucifera. In this Coccus nucifera, this diagram shows Coccus nucifera. In this Coccus nucifera, we have to observe that both flowers are developed in same plant. Female flowers and male flowers. See the diagram. In this diagram, we observe the female flowers and male flowers are in same plant. That is Coccus nucifera. Then, dioecious plants. Male, female flowers develop on the different plants. Examples are Borassus and Vallisneria plants. See the diagrams. This is the Borassus plant. Upper diagram is Borassus male plant, lower diagram is Borassus female plant. This is about the unisexuality. Next, going to the another adaptation, that is dichogamy. Dichogamy defines in some plants the androecium and gynoecium of bisexual flowers mature at different times. In some plants, the androecium and gynoecium of bisexual flower mature at different times. It is called as dichogamy. This dichogamy is an important device to avoid self-pollination. Dichogamy is of two types. Those are the protandry and protogamy. Once again, pronunciate these words, students. Protandry and protogamy. Protandry, proto means initially or first. Andry means androecium. Protandry defines in some dichogamous flowers the anthers mature before than the stigma. Anthers mature before than the stigma. Androecium mature before than the stigma is called as protandry. In the androecium, anther is present, that's why anthers mature before them. The stigma is called as protandry. Protandry example is Helianthus and Salvia. Then second one is protogyny. Protogyny. Gynoecium is matures earlier than the stamens are known as protogyny. It occurs in the bisexual flowers. Example is Solanum, Aristolochia, Ficus, Scrafularia. Protandry examples are Helianthus, Salvia, Clerodendron, Gossypium. This is about the protandry and protogyny in the dichogamy. This is above picture is above diagram explains about the protandry in the Clerodendron. This is a protandry in the Clerodendron. Stamens and styles are here. This is the rhododendron flower. Below the diagram is indicates as protogyny of Scrafularia. Scrafularia. In the Scrafularia protogyny, we have to observe the stigma and styles. This is protogyny. Protandrous flowers are much more common than the protogynous flowers. When both anthers and stigmas are ripened, there is usually an overlapping period. This is allows self-pollination if cross-pollination fails. Next adaptation is herchogamy. Herchogamy means in bisexual flowers, both male and female reproductive organs are arranged in different heights. This is called herchogamy. Herchogamy means different heights. Which are different heights? Both male and female reproductive organs are arranged in different heights in bisexual flower is known as herchogamy. In some flowers, stigmas are longer than the stamens. For this sentence, for this phenomenon, best example is hibiscus and tridax. Beside diagram indicates hibiscus, stigmas are longer than the stamens. In some flowers, stigmas bend in opposite direction to stamens. Example is gloriosa. See the beside picture. This is gloriosa superba diagram. Gloriosa superba flower. In this gloriosa superba, we observe the stigmas bend in opposite direction to stamens. This is also one of the example to the herchogamy. Next, going to the another adaptation, that is heterostyly. Heterostyly defines in same species of flowers, styles are arranged vary in height. Hetero means vary. Styles. In same species of the flowers, styles are arranged vary in height is known as a heterostyly. In some plants, it shows two types of flowers. Those are dimorphic flowers. In this dimorphic flowers, two types are there. Those are the long-styled flowers and short-styled flowers. Once observe this diagram, in this diagram we clearly distinguished observation. These are the heterostyly flowers. First picture is shown about the a long-styled heterostyle. Style is larger than the stamens. This flower is shows style is larger than the stamen. In the second picture, style is shorter than the stamens. Okay, this is heterostyle flowers. This heterostyle is a special adaptation to avoid self-pollination is commonly found in some members. Example is Primulaceae, Oxalidaceae, Polygonaceae, Plumbaginaceae, Rubiaceae families. Then another adaptation of cross pollination is self sterility. Self sterility means in same bisexual flowers, the pollen grains fall on the stigma of the flower, but the pollen grains are not germinated. This prevents self-fertilization. Examples are Abetulon and Passiflora. Beside pictures are Abetulon. Second one is Passiflora. These two plants are example to the self-sterility. Even though pollen grains are fall on the stigma of the flower, but these are not germinated. But when the pollen grains are fall on the another flower of stigma, they can germinate. It is called as self-sterility. Going to the next adaptation, that is pollen prepotency, means in some plants through pollination, pollen grains of one flower and same species of another flower pollen grains both are touched to the stigma. In this situation, first foreign pollen grains are germinated and show fertilization. This type of pollination is fertilization, known as cross fertilization. For this pollen prepotency example, plant is Dolichos labla. Last adaptation under the cross pollination, sensitive stigmas means in some flowers stigmas and stigmatic lobes are very sensitive to touch. This is known as sensitive stigmas. In those flowers, when cross pollination occurs once, the stigmatic lobes come closer and prevent self-pollination. Examples are Mimulus and Marpinia plants flowers. See the diagrams here now. This first diagram is Mimulus and second diagram is Marpinia. These are the best example for the sensitive stigmas. This is the topic of the Cantharomyces in the cross pollination. Thank you for watching this video.